Socio-environmental synthesis research relies on many different forms of information. This might include data collected by quantifying an event or outcome, running a computer simulation, collecting photographs, transcribing interviews, or capturing social media activity. In other words, highly heterogeneous data.
The growing availability of data and new ways to extract data have really fueled synthesis research, as well as interdisciplinary collaborations to address research problems that really can't be addressed by disciplinary approaches alone.
Work by sociologist Dr. Heather Randell and geographer Dr. Clark Gray provides an example of an interdisciplinary synthesis project focused on communities in rural Ethiopia. They integrated data on climatic conditions with socioeconomic, demographic, and educational attainment data to explore factors influencing educational outcomes.
We used the synthesis method for this research, and what that involved was combining temperature and precipitation data from Ethiopia with longitudinal household survey data on children's ages and schooling completed.
Heather and Clark's conceptual model depicted potential relationships between environmental change, agricultural production, and educational attainment for children living in farming households. It helped them to fine-tune their specific research questions and the type of data they needed.
We first assembled a relational database of the climate and social data, and then used logistic regression to test the hypothesis that climate variability influences educational outcomes among children from rural agricultural households in Ethiopia. Research like this is important because many people wouldn't think that climate change is affecting educational outcomes, but education is really important for multiple factors, including adaptation to future climate change. So it's important to think about how we can mitigate this relationship and ensure that kids stay in school in light of increasing climate variability and increasing extreme weather.
Their data ranged from economic indicators to demographic variables to characteristics of behavior, as well as climatic measures in gridded form. While heterogeneous, the various datasets had one variable in common: household location. So it was fairly straightforward to build a relational database. Their data were all quantitative, which is not always the case for many socio-environmental problems. The team did have to make decisions on how to disaggregate the data that were collected at scales larger than the household. As the team worked to organize and standardize such diverse data, they didn't have to assemble all of the datasets in the same place. Instead, the datasets could be interconnected by a computer network and a data model that specifies how to link them. This is known as a federated database. Federated databases are especially useful for teams that are geographically dispersed and that are bringing together many different datasets into a single analysis. The household-level survey data from Heather and Clark's study were all in categorical or numeric form, making it feasible to analyze their data and test their hypothesis using widely available statistical software. However, some teams that have qualitative information, such as that from textual sources or survey responses, are able to convert it to quantitative data.